All right, so in this video, let's talk about Google Sheets tables, how formulas work in Google Sheets tables, and what to expect from your formulas, and what's the reason you should or should not be using a table in Google Sheets. And to get started with a table, what we're gonna do here, we'll just add a couple of column names. And what we'll do, we'll simply just select something like this, go to this format, and then convert to table. So as you can see, I got this design, and on top here, you see we get this thing that says table one, which is essentially the name of this table. So let's go ahead and add some data. So I'm gonna add Olivia. And this will be a couple of columns from this table. Now, each one of these columns here, we can set the type of the column. So I can go here and set this to be a number or to be a currency or to be one of these other types. So right now I'll just do something like currency. And then for names, I'll click here, go to column type, and I'm gonna choose text for this column type, for this column. So we can define what type of data we should have in these columns. And basically the idea is gonna be is that if you enter a different type of data, let's say instead of a number here, I just enter hello, it will just highlight this with this validation in red that this is invalid data, but it still allows us to enter that information. So I'm gonna go ahead and just basically update this to a different number, and that creates this table now. So at this point now, one of the things about the table is that once you have a table, you can then refer to that data in that table using that table name up here. See, there's this table one is the name of the table. So that means if I wanted to calculate total amount from that quantity column, I could go here and do equal sum, open parentheses. And then I can type the name of the table being table one. And you can see as I start typing the name of the table, table, you can see it shows the name of the table, and then it shows these different columns from that table, like quantity, name, and then there's this all, and we'll talk about that, what that exactly means. But right now, I'm gonna choose this column quantity because that's what I want to sum, and then I'll close parentheses, hit enter, and that gives me the total. By the way, if you just go here and do equal sum, open parentheses, and simply just highlight these, you'll see it does the same thing. It does table one quantity, meaning the table one is the name of the table, and whatever is in square brackets, QTY, is the name of the column. I'm gonna hit escape and keep this one. You may have done this formula before using a regular range, and with a regular range, this would have looked like this. You would have done like sum, open parentheses, and then you would do like B2 colon B4, like this. And this will still give me that total. Now the difference is this. If I go here now and add another data point, let's say I add Linda to this and enter some amount for Linda, you'll see that this total I have here, which is referring to that table, will automatically update to include that total in this as well, because it understands that now we have a new line in this table. So what happens every time you add some data right below this, it becomes a part of this table. So if I do Tim here and add another data point, you'll see again, the same thing happens. But if you skip a line and you do something like Wendy here and then add a number for Wendy, that is not going to become a part of this table by default because I just skipped a line here. So that's how tables work. So every new line you add right below, that's a part of the table, but if you skip a line, it's not. Now, if you want this Wendy to be a part of the table, you still have the opportunity to do so. And I can do that by clicking on top here in this dropdown, in this table menu, and I can basically adjust this table range. So I can click here. See, now here is going from A1 to B6. Now I could update that to go to B8, hit okay, and now it's gonna cover this, and now you'll see my total here will automatically update now to also include that Wendy's number because now it's a part of the table. So let's go ahead and add another person here or just remove this line maybe. Another interesting thing that happens with tables, if I, for example, add another column here in this table, and that's gonna happen the same way. If I add the column right next to this, it will become a part of the table automatically. So I'm gonna enter a new column and I'll call this, let's say, duplicate. It's just a column name. So what I'll do here, I'll just create a formula that will take this number and multiply it by 2. So if I go here, do equals, point to this 45 and do times 2 like this. Notice when I press enter, it will fill this formula. So I'm just gonna accept this autofill. But possibly what's more important is that once this formula is applied for this whole column, if I now add another data point here and put a number here, you'll see that this formula is already here for this new line too. So it auto copies that formula now for any new line on this table as I add new data to this table. So now your formulas will be auto copied to the next row. Now, if you're one of the people who likes to use array formulas, you can still do array formulas too. So if I go here and do like array formula, I'll call that. So what I could do here, I could go here and do equals, and instead of just pointing to this 45, I could again point to this whole column in this table, which is from table 1 quantity column, and simply just multiply that, let's say, by 2. And to convert this to an array formula, I'm gonna press Command Shift Enter or Control Shift Enter, or you can just type array formula wrapper around this. And at this point, if I hit enter, you'll see that it will again copy this to a new line like this. And once again, if I add another data point here, let's do Rhonda and add some number over here. Once again, you'll see this way with the array formula, it still applies to this new line as well, because once again, it's gonna detect that this quantity column grew and there is another line in here. And basically this way, you don't have to refer to this whole column going all the way down with all these rows. And that would make your formulas work faster because it's gonna only work with the data that's in the table without having to deal with all the extra lines you possibly have below the table. And once again, this quantity keeps updating as we do this. Now, one other thing, I'm gonna delete this, is probably worth to mention is that this same syntax is also valid from a different sheet. So if I go here and add another tab, and I'm gonna call this one, double click and call this summary, once again, just do equals sum, open parentheses, and then I could type like the name of the table if I wanted to, like table 1, and that will show up, or I could, instead of doing that, after I open parentheses, I can go to this table and select this quantities column. And once again, it will do the same thing. I can close parentheses, press enter, and that would give me the same total. And again, if I right now look at this is 410. If I go to this table and add another 90 here. So at this point, if I go to summary, you'll see here as well, it's updating that to be 500. And notice nowhere here, I'm referring to this sheet here that's called table. I'm just pointing to that name of the table that's called table 1 and the column is called quantity. And that's pretty much how this works. Now, if you have existing data sets, if I go to this orders sheet like this one, and basically you want this data set to be converted to a table so that, again, as you do your formulas, as your data grows, it automatically includes those extra lines, you can go ahead and convert it to a table. So we can just go ahead and select this whole thing, go to format, click convert to table. And you can see up here, this is called table 2. So we should be able to also rename this tables. So instead of table 2, I'm gonna go here and name this table orders data. And now that's a new name for this table. So now this table is called orders data. And basically, if I wanted to now get the total of this, let's say sales amounts or whatever, once again, I'll do like a sum and I'll point to this orders data table sales amount column, which is this column right here. Close parentheses, hit enter. and that's my total. Once again, if I keep adding data to this, it will automatically just include that in this total the same way that happened before. Now, going back to this other sheet table, you can have multiple tables in the same worksheet. So I already have this table here that's called table one. Now I could just create another table here too. Let's say over here, I want another table. So I'll just select this, go to format and do convert to table. And you can see now yet another table. I can rename this columns. So I'm going to call this product name. And this I'll call price. And now I got another table, and this is called table two. I can rename this one as well. So I can call this products, maybe just products. So at this point, I can just list some products here. And once again, you can enter your numbers. And yet again, for each column, if you want this data type to be a certain data type, let's say this should be currency data type, we can do that. Now, if I go back to this orders one that I did over here, yet again, you can go here and each one of these columns here can get their own like data type as you see fit. Like maybe this should be currency. This, see, we have like shipped on hold processing. So for this one, I'm going to open this and choose a column type. And I'll do for this one, drop down column. And notice how it will automatically pick up all these different values I already have in this table. And using that, it's going to create this data validation dropdown. Hit done. Just like that, I could do the same for this. I could go here, edit column type, drop down for that too. It looks good to me. I'm going to hit done. And of course, as you keep adding data to this, so let's say I go here and add another line of data, it will apply those drop downs to this extra lines as we add new data to this. And with different columns like this, if you want to remove one of those columns, you can always just click on the drop down here and just do delete that column, and that's just going to disappear. Another thing you can do, if you have like repeating values, let's say you have Midwest, 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 you want to kind of group that together in one section, you can go here and group by column. And now you can see it's going to go and it's going to put all the East together, all the Midwest together, all the West together. You can see how we have this region West, region East, Midwest sections here. And then up here, if you click on this little views, you can see that's where your groups are. So you can see right now I'm under this temporary group by region view. So if I want, I can click here, exit view to get out of this and don't save this. And it's going to go back to the way it was before. So now it's not grouped by this column. It's just the way it used to be before. And then finally, as far as design goes, you can also just click here and choose either to have this alternating colors here. See how it's like white, gray, that to be on or off. Or if you don't like this green color design of the table, you can go customize table colors and choose different colors as you see fit. And then finally, there's also this option to delete table. So if I click that delete table, hit OK, it will basically delete the entire table. I'm going to go Command Z, Control Z to get the table back. And that's pretty much what you need to know about tables. So the most important part is to understand your table syntax and how it works and what happens as you keep adding data to your table. And this allows you to not have to link to an entire column of data. You can only pick the range you actually need. And as your table grows, it will adjust and pick up that actual range for you. And then finally, one thing I want to cover here is where I have this, well, let's work with this products one. So if I have this products table, if I wanted to sum this prices or average prices, what I do, I use my formula and then the table is called products. So if I keep typing the name of the table, see products, and open a square bracket here, it will basically give me this different column names. And you can see there is this price column, so I can point to that. There's the product name column, which is this one. I can point to that. But then there's also this all. So there are multiple ways you can refer to a table. One, you can refer to a column in a table, like price. You can refer to this other column, product name. You can also refer to the entire table by simply just typing products. Now, if you just type products, this products will refer to this table, but it's not going to include this column names in the range that you're picking up. So right now, this product name and price part is not included in the selection. Now, if you want to also include the headers for some reason, you could go here and open the square bracket and do this all. And that all will now refer to the entire table, also including this first line, which is your headers. So if you're doing some complicated index match and you're trying to match the header or whatever, you need to include the header. You can do so by doing this syntax all. And that should get you that. And that's pretty much it for this video. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe. And I'll see you in the next one.